Kentucky. You are the dearest land outside of heaven. Kentucky, I miss your laurel and your redwood trees. When I die, I want to rest upon a graceful mountain so
good friends and neighbors. This is Dad Everly talking for the Everly family. And we're going to play and sing you some songs, neighbors. Family style, also country style. And we got the whole gang on deck. Mom, Don, baby boy Phil. And you know, Mom, we kind of ought to tell the folks just how old these youngsters are. Some of the folks probably don't know. And Don, our oldest boy, is 15 years old. Phil's 13. Of course, me and Mom quit telling our age a long time ago. You know, I kind of
I miss the hound dogs chasing coon. I know that my mother, dad, and sweetheart are with.
Today we're in Muhlenberg County, and we have two special guests. First of all, it's Don Everly from the Everly Brothers.
Good to be here, Tim.
It's a wonderful thrill to have you on the show.
Well, believe me, this is my pleasure.
And we've got Mr. Pace, who is Mr. Everly's science teacher, correct?
He was my science teacher when I was in junior high.
Yeah.
Right out of grade school, went down to the junior high school in Shandor, Iowa, and him and his wife, Mrs. Pace, she taught me penmanship, Palmer method. And Mr. Pace taught me science and straightened me out.
Was he bad in class here?
Oh, I was a terrible student.
He was not the best student, but he was. He was genuine.
Yeah.
And so was his folks.
We've been out there trying to catch a few crappie today. They're not hitting yet, but we're going to catch them.
Oh, yeah.
And even if we don't,
It doesn't bother me at all.
What a wonderful place.
We got
gorgeous lake.
Yeah, isn't it wonderful here?
Now, we're staying at the
Lake Malone Inn,
which is now owned by you.
Yeah.
And there's some guitar picking that goes on there occasionally?
Yeah, well, tonight there'll be some.
Yeah?
Yeah, Friday and Saturday nights we just let whoever comes around play.
Oh, man.
And that's what it's going to be around. It's kind of casual.
Yeah, well, we're casual.
Tonight it's no big production. It's just who wants to pick, picks. It's pass the guitar around.
Now, Muhlenberg County, I guess you were born in Muhlenberg County.
Yeah, born in Brownie, Kentucky. Actually, it's not here anymore. That they did haul that one up and hauled it away.
They hauled it away.
I heard yesterday that the schoolhouse was saved from Brownie, Kentucky, and they did haul it over to Ebenezer, where they're going to maybe put a museum up to Merle Travis, Moe Schreger, Kennedy Jones, about the Southern, the Kentucky thumb pick guitar music, which is indicative of this area.
Right.
And this is where it originated. And where Merle Travis wrote the songs about the coal mines and things. And this has such a musical heritage.
And your dad
was a thumb picker.
Yeah.
Coal miner, thumb picker. And that thumb pick guitar got him out of the mines
Chicago. That's a good place to get away from.
Yeah, well, he got out of the mines with the guitar. That's what saved him. He went in the mines when he was 12 years old.
Wow.
Worked in those days when he went in. They sent him in. As soon as he could load the coal, they sent him in. Worked hard. Like a lot of people here in Kentucky, you know. But the guitar got him out of the mines, and that's where when I came along, I wound up on radio with him.
Right.
And I never did have to go to the mines. Otherwise, I'd have been probably a coal miner or something.
You eventually ended up in Chicago?
Well, it was Chicago. worked on radio there. Dad did, then I joined him in Iowa. We moved around a lot. Those shows didn't last that long. Right. We're a bit like itinerant musicians. We'd go where the job was, you know? And they liked to hear that music up there.
Right.
Yeah. So Dad was successful. And we did that right up till radio died out like that, live radio. And then records came in, that was in the late 50s.
There's a fish really knocking at that. Got a little bass. Whee!
A little bass. Got to grow up.
Well, we can't say we didn't catch anything.
That's right, we did not get skunked.
Have fun.
The song Phil and I was writing, like Dream and Kathy's Clown and stuff, I mean, it was from our heart, you know? And it wasn't to... I never thought of it as a delinquent, you know? But there was an attitude that we were delinquents, you know?
It's hard to believe, looking back, that you could think.
That we were.
Because it seems so innocent.
Yeah,
so
it was innocent. But there was a kind of a thing that, it was an attitude of that maybe you were stealing hubcaps in the parking lot out there, you know, when you weren't singing.
Some people can be bad. Things they do. They say.
Like I said, I was going to look for a little cabin on the lake.
Well, there it is.
And there it is.
Now that's all local rock.
Oh, local rock.
Stone. And you say there's a well over here?
There's a well here. This used to be a schoolhouse.
Oh, okay.
This building didn't, but the site was a schoolhouse.
Right.
And that was the well for the schoolhouse. And of course, it's covered good now so nobody can fall in. Made a little wishing well out of it.
You got a little pond right back
there's
over here?
There's a pond over here.
Do some bluegill fishing?
Yeah. It's called Lake Adela now.
Lake Adela? After your wife?
After my wife.
Maybe before the
game. I bless the day I found you. I want to stay around you. And so I beg you, let it be me. Don't take this heaven from one. If you must cling to someone now and forever, let it be me. When I'm with you, love, I find complete love. Without your sweet love, what would life be? So never leave me lonely. Tell me you love me only, and that you'll always let it be me. Say you'll always let it be me.
You see,
wow.
You're a musician.
That's
dream. Trouble is
I'm dreaming my life away. I need you so that I could die. I love you so, and that is why whenever